What happens when you give a stealthy flyer an $11 billion upgrade? A posh makeover? The F-22 Raptor, though set to be retired with the introduction of the next-generation air dominance fighter, is currently undergoing significant upgrades to ensure it remains a dominant force in the skies until its final flight. These upgrades, many of which are classified, aim to keep the Raptor at the forefront of aerial combat. Among the various enhancement efforts is a lesser-known initiative that could significantly shift the balance of power in the Pacific towards the U.S. Navy, the Air Force's Low Drag Tank and Pylon program. Although originally developed for the F-22, this program could become crucial for F-35 operations as well. The F-22 has an internal fuel capacity of about 18,000 pounds, providing it with a combat radius of approximately 679 miles. This allows the aircraft to reach a 679 miles away and return without refueling. However, to extend the F-22's range even further, the Air Force is exploring new solutions. The low-drag tanks and pylons are designed to enhance the Raptor's range without significantly compromising its stealth capabilities. How does it usually operate? It frequently operates with a pair of external fuel tanks, commonly known as drop tanks. Each of these drop tanks holds about 4,000 pounds of additional fuel, extending the Raptor's combat radius to approximately 980 miles. However, these drop tanks are not particularly stealthy, and even after they are jettisoned, a portion of the pylon remains, slightly compromising the F-22's stealth capabilities. This is where the low drag tank and pylon program come into play. These new, stealthy drop tanks will provide the F-22 with the same extended range without sacrificing its stealth. When these tanks are released, they will detach cleanly, leaving no pylon behind to diminish the Raptor's stealth profile even after the tanks are gone. This is a significant improvement for the F-22, especially in a potential conflict with a near-peer adversary like China. While these drop tanks would be highly beneficial for the Air Force, they could be even more crucial for the U.S. Navy. China's anti-access area denial strategy in the Pacific emphasizes the use of long-range anti-ship missiles to prevent foreign vessels from operating within vast areas of the South China Sea, extending more than 1,000 miles from Chinese shores. This strategy is exemplified by weapons like the DFZF, a hypersonic anti-ship weapon. The DFZF is a boost glide vehicle that is launched into the atmosphere via China's intermediate-range DF-17 ballistic missile. It is specifically designed to target American aircraft carriers from distances of about 1,000 miles. This poses a significant challenge for the U.S. Navy because its longest-range carrier-based fighter, the F-35C, has a combat radius of only around 670 nautical miles, or approximately 771 miles. This means that if a conflict were to arise, American carriers would have to sail close enough to China to launch combat missions, putting them well within the range of this nuclear-capable hypersonic anti-ship weapon. To address this issue, the Navy has several ongoing programs, such as the MQ-25 Stingray, a carrier-based drone refueler that can extend the combat radius of aircraft like the F-35C and FA-18. By flying out to refuel them mid-mission. Additionally, the Navy is developing the FA-XX, a sixth-generation fighter that is expected to be operational on aircraft carriers by 2035. While details about this new aircraft remain scarce, the Navy has indicated that it will offer significant improvements in speed, payload, and range. However, the F-35C is anticipated to continue serving alongside this new FAXX fighter for the next 40 years, meaning the Navy still needs a solution to the F-35C's range limitations. And here's where the low drag tank and pylon program enters the conversation. In August 2023, Lockheed Martin's Director of Advanced Aircraft Programs, O.J. Sanchez, stated that the low-drag tank and pylon program could be directly applicable to the F-35. While this doesn't guarantee that these stealthy tanks could be immediately attached to the F-35's wings, it does suggest that with some modifications, it might be possible. Keeping this in mind, I decided to do some rough calculations using publicly available data to determine if these new stealthy fuel tanks could provide the F-35C with the extended range it would need to engage targets in China. The F-35C already boasts the largest wingspan and the greatest internal fuel capacity of all F-35 variants, with the ability to carry approximately 19,700 pounds of fuel. This gives it a range of about 1,140 miles, or a combat radius of around 770 miles. However, if the F-35C were equipped with the F-22's stealthy underwing fuel tanks, each carrying an additional 4,000 pounds of fuel, its range could potentially extend to about 2,164 miles, providing a combat radius of approximately 1,082 miles. This would allow the carrier to remain just outside the reach of China's hypersonic anti-ship missiles, at least in theory. However, simply reaching the target is insufficient if the aircraft cannot carry a sufficient payload. The F-35C has a maximum takeoff weight of about 70,000 pounds, with a dry weight of 34,580 pounds. With the addition of 27,750 pounds of fuel and the weight of the tanks, only around 8,000 pounds would be left for the pilot and ordnance. But what can possibly neutralize Chinese defenses? The most effective weapon for neutralizing Chinese coastal defenses would likely be the stand-in attack weapon, which weighs approximately 1,030 pounds and can be carried internally by the F-35, preserving its stealth capabilities. Additionally, the F-35 can be equipped with the AIM-120D AMRAAM, the longest-range air-to-air missile currently in U.S. service, weighing about 350 pounds. The AM-9X, an infrared-guided short-range air-to-air missile, weighs around 187 pounds. Considering these weights, the F-35 would reach its internal storage capacity before it exhausts its payload capacity, making it entirely feasible to carry the additional weight of the new stealthy fuel tanks. The potential benefits of the low-drag tank and pylon program extend beyond just increased fuel capacity. The technology derived from this program, along with any modifications required to the F-35's wings, could open up further possibilities. For example, instead of carrying stealthy fuel tanks under the wings, the F-35 could be equipped with stealthy weapons pods. These pods would enable the aircraft to carry more ordnance into battle, without compromising its stealth profile, thereby enhancing its combat effectiveness in high-threat environments. However, it's crucial to recognize that this discussion remains hypothetical. In practice, aircraft are rarely flown to their absolute operational limits, although it's widely believed that the U.S. tends to underreport these limits for strategic reasons. Whether or not this concept becomes a reality will depend on the engineering expertise of the U.S. Navy, the U.S. Air Force, and Lockheed Martin. The successful integration of these technologies could significantly enhance the F-35's range and combat capabilities, providing a strategic advantage in potential future conflicts, particularly in contested regions like the South China Sea. This ends today's video. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more precise aviation videos.